The MultiPoint tracker is used to apply a blur to a logo, license plate, or person's face. The blur automatically adjusts in size, shape, and position as the object moves towards or away from the camera. Let's take a look and see how easy it is to do this. I'm going to start by right-clicking on this track, and I can either select Track Motion from here, or I can select it from the toolbar. This will bring me into the Track Motion dialog box. I'll just expand this. Within the dialog box, we have our scrubber bar along the bottom. I have the ability to turn on and off track paths, as well as set the type of track and the mask mosaic. I'm going to select the tracker, and then I'll select Multi-Point Track. And now it's simply a matter of moving these nodes into the position where I want to track my object. Very quick and very easy, I can position these. You'll note that as I'm doing this, I have a magnification lens that makes it much easier for me to accurately position these nodes. Once I've done that, it's simply a matter of clicking on Track Motion. You'll see that as my vehicle moves back, it's dynamically changing the positioning of that track. And that's all there is to it. You'll notice I have my track lines. To allow for easy editing, I have the ability to turn these off. I'm happy with that. I'm simply going to set the size of my mosaic. I'm going to drop this down a little bit. Let's make that down to about 15. And then it's simply a matter of clicking OK. That returns me back to VideoStudio. I can now click on this track, go ahead and play this, and you'll see that my object is masked out. Now let's try this with a different clip. I'm going to drag and drop this clip onto my timeline. I'll zoom to the entire duration of that. And again, right click, and I'm going to select Track Motion. One thing you'll notice in here is that I have a 1-2-3 approach that'll easily tell me how to go about the process of tracking motion on this. Let me go ahead and maximize my screen. I'm going to make sure my track is selected. I'll click on a Multi-Point Tracking. And then it's simply a matter of moving my nodes into position. Again, we can see the magnification window makes it easy to drag these into place. Once I've done that, it's simply a matter of clicking on Track Motion. Now, in a situation where the nodes have come off from the original position, it's easy enough just to back up a few frames, either by grabbing my scrubber, or I can go back a few frames at a time, and I can reposition these points. Once I've done that, it's simply a matter of clicking on Track Motion again. Down here, I'm going to set my adjust mosaic size. I'm going to bring that down to 15. And then again, simply click OK. Now, if you want to get really fancy, you can now match motion. What this will do is it will allow you to place an element, such as text, or a graphic element like a speech bubble that maybe says, your ad here, drop that onto an overlay track, and then simply right-click and select match motion. So as you can see, it's relatively easy to ensure privacy or mask out an object that you do not want others to recognize. Hope you've enjoyed this brief tutorial on multi-motion tracking. What types of projects will you be using this feature on? Did you like this tutorial? If so, be sure to subscribe to our channel. And if you're looking for more resources, such as tips, contests, and tutorials, go to learn.corel.com and sign up for exclusive email updates. Thanks for watching.